All right, guys, you are going to position yourself into a squatting stance, toes facing forward, and let's squat. Make sure your knees do not go over your toes. All right, feet together and slightly apart. Lean backwards, not forwards. You should be able to raise your toes up if you are squatting correctly. Spread your feet wide again, this time turn your toes out and squat down. Don't fall forward, guys. All right, feet now shoulder width apart. Same thing, dropping down for that squat. Make sure not to just bend with your back. You need your legs moving. Use those thighs. You got this. All right, this time, you're going to take one side, and you're going to lean. You're going to take it in an L shape. And we're gonna lean forward, all right, to the forward pointing leg. Just like if you were in a back stance. Other side, switching that up. Going to the other side with your leg. All right, moving those feet back. We're gonna do it one more time, straight forward. Way to work, guys. Today is a forms day, and I am super proud and excited about the fact that the majority of you already know your forms. Okay, now if you don't know all of your form, I want you to go back and I want you to review your form. Okay, so I need you to go back to one of the previous form videos. Potentially the breakdown video would be best for you. I want you to go through the detailed breakdown and practice that form with me. Okay, now if you already have your form after this class video, I want you to go do your form 10 times on your own and one time super detailed on your own as well, where I want you thinking of what stance am I doing, what chambers, what technique goes into this. Okay, so if you already know your form 10 times and one detailed breakdown after the class video. Okay, so because the majority of you do know your forms, it's giving us the opportunity to be able to work on your definitions in class. So what we're gonna do is I am going to say your definition out loud and kind of break it down to where it'll be easier to memorize. And then hopefully you'll be able to repeat back at me if your belt color is furthest away. So if, since we're doing high ranks, if you're a brown belt and you don't necessarily want to go through June Goon definition for purple belts and Warang definition for red belts, you can fast forward to the brown belt section and just do your definition. Okay, if you are a purple belt and we finish your definition June Goon first one, you can fast forward the red and brown belts to the ending stretching session. Okay, so After we do your definition, move on to stretching. If your definition is one of the last ones, move past the first couple and get to your definition so we can work on it. Do you understand? All right, awesome. Let's get started. All right, guys. So, Jun Goon, this is our purple belt form. So, purple belts, we should be working on your definition right now. Okay? So, Jun Goon was named after the patriot An Jun Goon, who assassinated Hirobumi Itō. Okay? We're going to say that part again. I know it was a lot of weird words. Okay? So, Jun Goon, you know this word, okay? Jun Goon is named after the patriot An Jun Goon, who assassinated Hirobumi Itō. Okay, one more time. So Jun Goon is named after the patriot An Jun Goon, who assassinated Hirobumi Itō, the first Japanese governor general of Korea. Okay, so he was the first Japanese governor general of Korea. That's impressive. Okay, so going back, Jun Goon is named after the patriot An Jun Goon, who assassinated Hirobumi Itō, the first Japanese governor general of Korea, known as the man who played a leading role in the Korea-Japan merger. There are 32 movements in this pattern to represent Mr. An's age when he was executed at Luisheng Prison in 1910. Okay, we're going to say it again. So Jun Goon was named after the patriot An Jun Goon, who, do you remember what he did? Who assassinated Hirobumi Itō, the first Japanese governor general of Korea. Okay, do you remember what's next? He was known as the man who played a leading role in the Korea-Japan merger. The 32 movements in this pattern represent Mr. An's age when he was executed at Luisheng Prison in 1910. Okay, so now we're going to say it all the way through, no stopping. Okay, all right. Jun Goon is named after the patriot An Jun Goon, who assassinated Hirobumi Itō, the first Japanese governor general of Korea, known as a man who played a leading role in the Korea-Japan merger. The 32 movements of this pattern represent Mr. An's age when he was executed at Luisheng Prison in 1910. Okay, so purple belts, if you need to rewind and listen to this over and over again and say it over and over again, you definitely can. If you have it, go ahead, fast forward to stretching at the end. And if you don't have it, but if you would prefer to write it down, go ahead and fast forward to the end where we have your definition in written words. Okay, and you can take a picture of it, you can pause it and write it down while it's on the screen, or you can even go into our Spark app and click curriculum, and there's actually a definitions tab. And if you click that, it has all the definitions for all the forms. Okay, awesome job, purple belt. Moving on to red belts. Okay, red belts. Are y'all ready for y'all's definition of Warang? Okay, so Warang was named after the Warang Youth Group, which originated, guess where? It's somewhere you've actually memorized. If you have other definitions memorized, you should have heard it in the past. Okay, so it was the Silla Dynasty. So Warang is named after the Warang Youth Group, which originated in the Silla Dynasty in the early 7th century. The 29 movements refer to the 29th Infantry Division, where Taekwondo developed into maturity. Okay, so yours is not as long as everyone else's. You got this. Okay, we're gonna try again. Warang is named after the Warang Youth Group. Okay, so say that again. Warang is named after the Warang Youth Group, which originated in the Silla Dynasty. in the Silla dynasty. Okay, so Warang is named after the Warang youth group, which originated in the Silla dynasty in the early 7th century. In the early which century? In the early 7th century. The 29 movements refer to, do you remember? They refer to the 29th Infantry Division, where Taekwondo developed into maturity. Okay, so one more time. Warang is named after the Warang youth group, which originated in the Silla dynasty in the early 7th century. The 29 movements refer to the 29th Infantry Division, where Taekwondo developed into maturity. Okay, so red belts, you guys can, if you already haven't memorized, go ahead, fast forward to stretching at the end. If you don't have it memorized and you would like for me to say it to you some more, go ahead, rewind, rewatch it as many times as you need. And if you think that you would learn it better from reading it or from writing it, go ahead and at the very end, we're gonna have your definition up in words on the screen. And that way you can pause it, you can take a picture, you can write it down, do whatever you need. And then lastly, another great way to get this down is in our Spark app, there's actually a curriculum tab that says definitions. If you click that, it should have your Warang definition and you can use that as well. Okay, so awesome job, Red. Move on to stretching. All right, brown belt. So your definition is, of course, the Chung Mu definition. So this definition is really long, but I know you can get it. Okay, yours is almost like telling a story. Okay, so Chung Mu was the name given to the great admiral Yi Sun Sin of the Li dynasty. Okay, let's say that again. Chung Mu was the name given to the great admiral Yi Sun Sin of the Li dynasty. Okay, one more time. Chung Mu was the name given to the great admiral Yi Sun Sin of the Li dynasty. He was reputed to have invented the first armored battleship, the Kubokosin. I'm even saying it like a story, man. It is a story, okay? So, Chung Mu was the name given to the great admiral Yi Sun Sin of the Li dynasty. He was reputed to have invented the first armored battleship, the Kubokosin, in 1592. In 1592, remember that, okay? Which is said to be a precursor to the present day submarine. Precursor means something that came before. One of the original things that is the reason why we have submarines is because of the Kubokosin. Okay, so Chung Mu was the name given to the great admiral Yi Sun Sin of the Li dynasty. He was reputed to have invented the first armored battleship, the Kubokosin, in 1592, which is said to be a precursor to the present day submarine, which is pretty cool. Okay, moving on. The reason this pattern ends with a left hand attack is to symbolize his regrettable death, having no chance, none, to show his unrestrained potentiality checked by the forced reservation of his loyalty to the king. That is a lot of big words, so we're gonna rewind, okay? So we're gonna go after the present day submarine part, okay? Because that part is all like a story and then it turns into a bunch of big words. So we're gonna say that part quickly and then we're gonna slow it down at the end, okay? So Chung Mu was the name given to the great admiral Yi Sun Sin of the Li dynasty. He was reputed to have invented the first armored battleship, the Kubokosin, in 1592, which is rumored which is said to be a precursor to the present day submarine. Okay, now here's where it gets tricky. The reason why this pattern ends in a left hand, so your left hand attack, is to symbolize his regrettable death, having no chance to show his unrestrained potentiality. So say unrestrained potentiality checked by the forced reservation of his loyalty to the king. Lots of big words. So the reason why this pattern ends with a left hand attack is because of his is to symbolize his regrettable death. Regrettable death. Having no chance to show his unrestrained potentiality checked by the forced reservation of his loyalty to the king. That's a lot. You're probably gonna have to rewind this and hear this one a lot. Okay, so one more time all the way through. Okay, so Chongmu was the name given to the great Admiral Yi Sun Sin of the Li Dynasty. He was reputed to have invented the first armored battleship, the Kubokosin, in 1592, which is said to be a precursor to the present-day submarine. The form ends in a left-hand attack due to his regrettable death, having no chance to show his unrestrained potentiality checked by the forced reservation of his loyalty to the king. So if you guys need to, of course, rewind, rewatch it. We are also going to be putting your definitions at the end after stretching. They're going to be typed out. You can take a picture of them, pause it, write it, whatever you need to do. And then another cool thing you can do is in our Spark app, there's actually a definition tab under curriculum. If you click that, you should be able to find your definition and it'll be written out for you as well. Okay, you got this, guys. Let's go.